So I'd just like to officially declare the University of Central Lancashire's Medical School open.
So I would just like to say to Kate, thank you, thank you, thank you for giving us some of your very precious time. I know of no one who's visited this university whose time is more precious. I don't think that opening a medical school is on many people's bucket list, but I'm really glad it's on yours, Kate. What Kate didn't say is, you know, may God bless this medical school, and may all your students always, always, always treat patients like people and put patients at the heart of everything they do. That's the reason we invited Kate to open our medical school, because she's putting back what's important in medicine, and we want to start as we mean to go on. So, as Mike says, it won't be long before we're the best medical school out there. We mean to carry on, we mean to carry Kate's message forward, and we mean to make Kate's legacy part of our norm. So thank you, Kate.
Historically, it's the first new university in the UK to have a medical school, which is a fantastic achievement. Raises our profile, expands our curriculum portfolio, gives us a global overview. Look at all the students around you. And of course, gives us a foundation for the future growth of medicine in the Northwest region.
The School of Medicine here at UCLan is unique. It provides for an education that will be sent globally because of the international nature of our medical students. They will have an excellent medical education because of the small number of students and the high number of high quality staff. I think this school has a great opportunity to contribute to the health economy of the region in general by producing not only fantastic members of healthcare staff who hopefully will one day go on to practice in the region, but also to provide opportunities for staff working in the region to become involved in their education and to become involved in the research that will help to provide better patient care globally, nationally, for everyone.
I think the school's in a unique position because we've established the institute, the school, in an area of high health needs and high health educational needs. We were wondering whether we'd get the cooperation with the local authorities, the local clinicians, health providers, and it's been incredible the response we've had. Both here in central and east Lancashire, but also further north in Cumbria, South Cumbria. We're going to make an enormous contribution in terms of our ability to provide healthcare workers, professionals, but also really influence policy to really make a difference on what the region and perhaps the wider region beyond this area have a huge difference to the health of this area.
There are numerous essential qualities for doctors. We need to have vast knowledge of our anatomy, physiology, pharmacology, but there are also those human qualities that I think are so essential to be a good doctor. An ability to communicate with people well, an ability to empathise and show your compassion, and an ability to build connections and trust and relationships with people. Communication is something that we can never see as we've just ticked the box and learnt about it and it's just that's it done. It's a lifelong thing that we learn about day in, day out until the day we retire from medicine. And so for training doctors, it's vital, and it's probably, you know, the time when you learn most about communication, but it carries on for the rest of your career. I believe the little things are actually huge, and they're the things that I remember about my care. So I remember the person that held my hand when I was upset, or that person that had that extra moment for me when I needed somebody to talk to. Perhaps somebody who sat down next to me rather than standing over me, or the person that gets my husband a cup of coffee when we've been up all night in hospital. It's those little things, they really make a big difference. Training doctors have a huge amount to offer to the future of the health service. They are the future, along with our training nurses, our training pharmacists, our training physiotherapists. They are the people who are going to become the future leaders of our health service. So if they have the right values to start off with, then we're going to get a health service that is compassionate, that does think of patients before finances, and does really make a difference to those people.
I feel very excited to be one of the first students at UCLan. It's kind of a privilege to me being selected out of the many people that applied. It's all about patients. The patients really feel at ease and comfortable and feel like sharing and trusting, you know, us doctors with their information and believing us, you know, for them to receive the utmost care. I hope to, you know, impact, you know, the lives of everyone around me in a positive way.
I'm so proud to be the first cohort medical student in University of Central Lancashire, because I do think that it is being a part of this historical, memorable moment in this event is like make me proud of it. I want to become a caring and knowledgeable doctor who can put my patients in the first place, so I can put their best interests and their concerns as my priority.
A unique opportunity for the young individuals of the future to learn their trade in a manner that's going to primarily benefit the patient population.
UCLan Medical School, it's a great medical school.